Hello everyone, my name is Emily. I'm a freshman graphic design major studying art of the Western world, and I'm going to tell you about some art. Okay, so the specific piece I'm going to talk about is called The Annunciation with St. Margaret and St. Ansonus. This was created around the year 1333 by artist Simone Martini. Before diving into the details about the work itself, I'm going to talk about Mr. Martini himself. So, what brought him to the point of creating this altarpiece, and what brought him to be an artist? Well, first, he was born. That happened in Siena in 1284, where he was raised. Although we don't know much about Martini or his childhood, it is likely that he became an artist's apprentice at a young age because of the culture at the time. Eventually, he began working solo and made his first public piece, which was a portrayal of Mary and the child Jesus. After completing other works, he arrived at the Siena Cathedral and made the Annunciation altarpiece. For this specific work, Martini was helped by his brother-in-law, Lippo Memmi. Although there is no record of who actually painted which parts, it's commonly thought among art historians that Martini painted the center panel and Lippo Memmi did the side panels. The Annunciation altarpiece is made of wood panel, gold leaf, and tempera paint, which is a mixture of egg yolk and pigment. The piece is a triptych, meaning there are three separate parts that make up the entire work. The first panel, starting on the left, features Saint Ansonus, the patron saint of Siena. Saint Ansonus is shown wearing rich people clothing because he was born into imperial Roman nobility. He converted to Christianity at age 12 and was soon beheaded, which is why he is shown beardless or young-looking. Above St. Ansonus is Jeremiah, a prophet in Christian tradition. Moving over to the middle panel, we see the angel Gabriel bringing the news that she would give birth to a son. Gabriel, on the left, appears to have just swooped in, startling Mary. Gabriel is holding an olive branch, a symbol of peace, in one hand. The other hand appears to be pointing upwards, towards the figure at the top. This figure is a representation of the Holy Spirit. Between the angel Gabriel and Mary is a vase with lilies in it, and some words written in Latin. The vase and lilies are a symbol of purity, specifically that of Mary. The Latin words say, Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, or Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Mary, on the right of the center panel, is shown holding a Bible and wearing the same colors she is traditionally shown in. Above the center panel are images of Ezekiel and Isaiah. These are two more Christian prophets. The final panel shows Saint Margaret and Daniel, the final prophet. The background of the work is made of gold leaf, which tends to flatten and lose a sense of depth in a work of art. Martini combats the flatness by creating a ground for the figures to sit on, giving the scene a little bit of depth. The Annunciation altarpiece was made for the St. Ansonus Chapel in the Cathedral of Siena, but it has since been moved to the Uffizi in Florence. So why is this work important? Martini's Annunciation is a great example of Sienese Gothic painting. These types of paintings are similar in that they use elegant color and line. This work is also important because it is a sort of template in which other artists use to make similar works from this point onward. Not only that, but it is something that will continue to be used for many years to come.